Get my words right and then approach you. When I'll treat you like a man is supposed to, you'll never have to cry. No, I know everyone can relate to when they find a special someone. And she's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my one of a kind, no. The way she moves to her own beat, she has the qualities of a queen. She's a queen. Ooh, ooh, what a natural beauty. No need no makeup to be a cutie. She's a queen. She's a queen. And when they ask what a good woman's made of, she's not afraid and ashamed of who she is. She's royal, yeah, so royal. And I need her in my life. I never knew anyone until the night that I seen her eyes. So sweet, I can see it in her eyes, the way she smiles. Hey, yes, I and I know the king and queen crown, see I'm tied, so I'll never leave your side. Just stick with me through the trial times. Oh, and she says she no mind. Her right to no good man is hard to find. And she can't about that giant line. That's why she has no ties at this time. Yeah, I know many men are trying, but she needs to be more than wine and dine, because she's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life. I never knew anyone so divine. The way she moves to her own beat, she has the qualities of a queen. So supreme. Ooh, ooh, but a natural beauty. No need no makeup to be a cutie. She's a queen. So supreme, yeah. And when they ask what a good woman's made of, she's not afraid and ashamed of who she is. She's royal, yeah, so royal. And I want her in my life.
Hi,
so one of a kind. No, no, the way she moves to her own beat, she has the qualities of a queen. My Nubian queen. Ooh, ooh, what a natural beauty.
Actually, you're supposed to be drinking alcohol now, not water.
No, giddy. Awa. Girl. I didn't be that. Hey, plastic, I know. Tell everybody, tell them, make them know. I know if you don't show, they don't come again with a brand new one. Everybody follow me. Get it, girl. And you know. And you know. And you know.
All right, we have a small technical glitch. Mom is taking care of that.
We're back and back and back. Okay. We're about to start. Thank you for joining us. It's Oche Kitchen again live today with you and introducing others.
Mama, go ahead and introduce everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. And welcome to Oche Kitchen. It's Saturday, the 23rd of May, 2020. It's another fun night for all of us. A fun time, I would say. In the house, and I'm Ifeoma Mom and Badinoju. I've got IJ Wanwu. OJ Bekelicious, Winifred Iwanigo, and we've got our favorite guest, Chi. Chi, welcome. And everyone out there, thank you for joining us, and we'll have great fun today. I'll hand over to IJ to introduce the beautiful topic of the day.
All right, thank you everybody for tuning in and having time for us. The topic for today is questions men are dying to ask us. You know, men have so many questions to ask us. The first one, let's go right into it. The first one is, I think, Winifred, can you be the first to answer this? How big is too big and how small is too small?
As regards to what? In what context?
When a man says, how big is it? The cassava, the mandingo. How big is too big and how does size matter to you?
Okay. I think it depends on the personality though, you know. Size does matter. Then again, it really doesn't. If you know how to use it. That's the thing. I once dated somebody. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yeah. Okay. For instance, I once dated somebody, you know, for years, I never came. Yeah. It was the mandingo was big. Everything was okay, but I never came.
Yeah.
You know, and I once dated somebody else who didn't have that size and all of that, and at the slightest thing I will just come just like that.
Yes,
so I don't think it's about the size, it's just how well. That's what I think.
Okay. OJ, can you continue? Does size matter to you?
I'll pass on this one.
You pass on this one. Okay, Mama, does size matter to you?
I think that in one sentence, well endowed does not mean highly skilled.
Exactly, yeah. Oh, okay, that's it. Okay. For me, I would say it does matter and it doesn't matter. Like Winifred says, and same thing you said too, if it's big and you can't use it, it doesn't make sense. I mean, and if it's small, you can walk it or can use it. So if you're small, you have to figure out a way to, you know, better your skills and stuff like that. So for some people that say the size matters, that once it's big, at least if it goes in, it fills it up. But you have to know how to, you know what I mean? Use it, dig it, and, you know, do all kinds of stuff and everything. All right. Chi, do you have anything to say? Chi, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Do you have anything?
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Do you have anything to say? Does size really matter? How big is too small? And how big is too big and how small is too small? Do you think it matters?
Well, it matters, like you said, it doesn't matter. Then when it matters, I mean, is if it's too big, way too big that you won't be able to carry it.
Exactly, yeah.
You know, because some of them, when they are too big, believe me, when you're making love, you're not going to enjoy it. You feel like it's coming up here, like.
Yes.
Then when it's too small, there's a way, we are Igbos, right? So yeah. There's a way my mother will always say it, you know, when she wants to talk shitty. She said, it feels like you know, like feather. So it matters, it doesn't matter. I mean,
yeah,
moderate size is good, and when you got it, you know how to use it.
Exactly.
All right.
This one is Oje, can you take away this one? Do women like abs or arms more?
I, for one, I do not like muscular men.
Yes.
If you're into bodybuilding and you're all hunky, it actually scares me. I feel like you're going to squeeze me to death one day.
Yeah.
So for me, if you're nicely toned and you look okay, moderate, it's fine by me. It doesn't really matter. I don't even want the arms. If you're not pregnant as a man, yeah, it's okay, yeah, by me.
That's cool. All right. Winifred, can you take it away?
It doesn't really matter to me.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that you have to be a blob.
Yeah.
You know, growing up, you know, in your teens, you'd say yourself, ooh, I want a tall, dark, slim, handsome guy. But as you grow older, you learn, you know better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that it is all about being tall, six packs and all of that. It's all about the personality.
Yeah.
You know, so it doesn't really matter to me.
Mama, take it away. You like it all? Your thing is on mute.
As if you have my answers. What's up? I'm a petite lady. Ideally, I tell you what I like. With no disrespect to my partner, mm-hmm, I've always liked pairing up to somebody who is larger and big, but I'm not too keen on muscular people.
Yeah.
And looking at my grandmom from the maternal side, my grandmom has got my stature, a petite woman, mm-hmm, and her husband is quite taller. But when for me, those physical aspects doesn't mean anything to me. It's the person. So I haven't got a very tall husband, but okay. I'm happy.
Do you got something? No?
For me, I don't, for muscular, man, it's not really my type, you know. Because sometimes I look at them, I'm like, what is this?
For me, I don't care about muscles, but I love arms. I love long arms and I love long legs. So I'm an arm and leg person. So because all I'm thinking is the wraparound, you know, aspect of the relationship. So I love long arms. So I'm an arm girl. All right. Ogechi, welcome to the show. The third question is, how frequently do girls masturbate? If I'm a mama, can you take it away from me? How frequently do girls masturbate? Ifoma, you're on mute.
Okay. No, so I would say that girls masturbate all the time, subconsciously. You don't know when you do it. When you're having a shower, you're all over your body. For some sensitive people, it triggers a sensation for them and they achieve a result. No matter how little. Mm-hmm. But for those who are stronger, it wouldn't mean anything to them.
Yeah.
And you know, there's this thing people do. Oh my God, you hold yourself. And that's the first place you touch.
Yes.
That's the masturbation in another form. Not a serious business, not the serious type of it. So I think women do it all the time.
So you're saying women subconsciously masturbate all the time.
Gotcha.
Winifred, can you take it away? How frequently do girls masturbate?
How frequently do we girls masturbate?
Yeah.
I would say I think it's different for everybody. You know. For me, I'll use myself as an example. Whenever I finish my period and all of that, I feel very horny and then I masturbate and all of that. And that's it. I don't enter the bathroom to shower and then I start maybe touch when water touches my knee. My goodness, no, that has never happened to me before.
Yeah,
that has never happened to me before at all. So if I want to masturbate, you know, it's usually after my period and all. That's when I'm really at my peak, and then that's when I do it.
All right.
I guess it's like that for some people as well.
All right. Oje, do you have something to say? Oje. Chi, you have something to say?
Yeah. For shower, no, I don't. You know, because for me, when you're in the shower having a bath, it's like you're having a bath, you want to do it and get out. So, and for masturbate, I think the meaning is like, you know, when you have the feeling of any sexual pleasure or something. So it has to be like a certain period.
Yeah.
Maybe like Winifred said, after your period, or maybe your husband traveled or something that would trigger it. So, yeah, but for me, I wouldn't say because I don't know.
For me, I'm more like mama. I have a sensitive body. It could happen anywhere for me. So it could be in the shower. I have a shower head, you know what I mean? If you take it out and you know what I mean, it triggers shit. So it could happen, I would say often, yeah.
Yeah, because I also know someone who says even when she eats banana, sweet things.
Oje, can you hear us? Yeah, we were asking how frequently do girls masturbate? You're passing? Okay. We're welcoming Ogechi and Ego and Oluchi and another person.
Why is OJ passing it? We want to hear her.
let her go. Ego, do you have anything to say? Or should we move on? Your phone is on mute.
Okay, I was just going to say that I get too much of the real deal that I don't get to
It doesn't have anything to do with the real deal. Anyway, no, I mean, just so you know. Anyway, let's Ego, do you have something to say towards it? How often do girls masturbate?
I don't know how to answer that question because
that's okay. I wasn't sure if you wanted to answer.
Yeah, because it's something I don't do, so I don't know how often. Okay. But I'm learning a lot today, actually.
That's the goal of this program. Okay, let's move to the fourth question. Do girls find it attractive if a guy claims to have a lot of options? Number four, do girls find it attractive if a guy claims to have a lot of options? Like they have a wife, a side chick, and you still want to go with the guy. Do girls find it attractive if a guy claims to have a lot of options? Come on, man, take it away.
Yeah, you made it sound so simple. When defining a guy with a lot of options is simply talking about those sharp guys. If I'm not getting you, I've got another lady waiting for me out there. So don't even mess with me. So talking about the sharp guys, I guess that's why you have that picture. You have that sharp pepper there and that shark. All those shark guys. Anyway, I'll be honest with you. Yes, I find them attractive. I don't like dull things. I like people with activity. Although I wouldn't like so many activities played around my head, but I like people that have action in them. Simply because I believe that those people that claim to be gentle are not being honest. So it may be them that are sharp, that are doing the same deal, but they're just pretending. So that's why I would rather settle for the sharp guys.
The devil
that have options.
The devil, you know. Mm-hmm. All right. Winifred, do you have something to say about that?
I didn't get the question, please.
Do girls find it attractive if a guy claims to have a lot of options? Like, if I don't get you, I'm moving on to the next girl. I have a girlfriend, I have a wife, I have a side chick, I have it all. Do you think girls find it attractive?
What's attractive about that? Why would you want to get yourself entangled in something like that?
Okay.
It's nice being honest, right? Mm-hmm. And then you give me the option to, you know, dabble into it or not dabble into it. But I wouldn't want to dabble into it if somebody approaches me and tells me that, you know, if you don't agree, I have options and all of that. We all do have options, right? We all have options, but I am not going to dabble it in front of you that, okay, if it doesn't work out, I go and start dating somebody else. No, I don't find that attractive at all. It doesn't
Okay. All right. Oje, do you find it attractive?
No.
Okay. No.
Because I find it... in as much as I like competition, but not in everything. Mm-hmm. I don't want somebody toying with my emotions and telling me you have, then go to those people. Why come to me? So it's a no-no for me. It's actually a huge turnoff.
I think I find it attractive because I'm that. If I was a guy, I'll be like that because I'm that kind of person. Okay. let's move. For the audience, if you have questions, can you raise your hand so that because we're running against time. So I'll just bypass some questions. Okay. Do I pursue a girl who's canceled on me twice? The guys want to know, do I pursue a girl who's canceled on me twice? Chi, you have anything to say about it?
Can you say that again?
Do I pursue a girl who's canceled me twice? Are you guys looking at the screen? Do you see the whiteboard? The questions are on the whiteboard. Okay.
Right. So what are they trying to ask? Are they trying to say, do I still go ahead and try one more time or something?
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah, for me, I would say if you really like the girl, because let's not go to love first. If you really like the girl, maybe you try one more time because there may be some reasons why the girl did what she did, then you give it a benefit of doubt because they said you try one, two, but the third one, in Igbo language, there's a way they say it. So I believe in that. There's a one and a third one. That's the, you know, so right. Yeah, you don't just give up like that.
All right, Oje.
You really like the person.
All right, thank you. Oje, do you pursue a girl who's canceled on you twice? As a guy, do you?
It depends on why she canceled. If she canceled because she took ill or she had an emergency, then by all means, go ahead. But if it's obvious that she's just trying to make Inyanga, trying to be a diva, I don't think there's any point, because if she wanted you from the get-go, she'll make herself available.
All right. Mama.
Which of the mamas?
Oh, Ify mama. Ify mama. Small mama.
So, yes. Okay. I'll advise them to keep pursuing. Because some women, personally, I don't waste time. If I want something, I say yes. I don't dabble. But I know there are women that like that long drama. So if you really want that person, go ahead with that long drama. Again, it's possible some women delay with responses because there are other things they're trying to sort out. They're trying to finish up with one person to do this one. One person is delaying them. So keep chasing them. Don't give up. Give them more time. Twice is too short to cancel for you to give up now, unless you're not serious.
All right. Winifred.
They say in life, if you fail, you try again. So if you try, you don't succeed, you keep on trying. It's just like you're going into a business and you fail. And you say, because you failed, you're not going to go into another business, or you're not going to continue striving to succeed. So you keep on trying and trying until one day, definitely, she'll just say, this guy has been on my case for a while right now. Okay, let me just go and do lunch with him. And the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a step. And from the lunch, anything can happen. You know?
If I'm a guy, I won't even bother because I don't have time for patience. I'm impatient. I won't bother. I'll move on to the next best thing. So,
thank God you're not a guy.
Thank God, though. But I was raised amongst guys, so maybe that's why I am the way I am. Oluchi, you have anything to say? Oh, no. No, okay. The next question is, do girls actually like dick pics?
What?
Do girls actually like sexting? Like, you know, a guy sending you, pictures of, you know, dick pics, yeah. Okay, OJ, you are already shaking your head. You don't want it. Winifred, do you like dick pics?
No.
If I'm a mama, do you like dick pics?
Yeah, if you understand it, I can see.
I do. Anybody else have something to say? Okay,
just
Chi,
for the fun of it, because just for the fun of it, Chi wants something.
Yeah, Chi, go ahead. Do you like dick pics?
If you stand to me, man, I'll look at it. See how it is.
So we win. It's three over two. We love guys, we love it. So keep sending it. The next question is it okay to wake up? Is it okay for your girl to wake you up in the middle of the night for a sex session? So guys are asking, is it okay for them to wake us up in the middle of the night for a sex session? Winifred, can you take it
to
away?
To disturb our sleep the other way around.
For me,
Winifred,
yeah.
What do you think?
I don't like it at all. Then I'll be sleeping and then somebody will now wake me up, maybe after the first marathon, and then in the middle of the night, say like 2-3 a.m. and I'll be deep asleep, and then you wake me up to have sex. No. It's a no-no for me. It's really annoying. Annoying is the word, especially if I have to go do something in the morning. Even if I don't have anything I'm going to do in the morning, don't wake me up in the middle of the night for sex. It's annoying. I enjoy my sleep at that time.
All right. OJ, do you have something to say about that? Please tell me you love it.
No, I wanted to say something about Winnie's response first. She said, especially after the fourth marathon, what if you didn't have any before you guys went to bed? It's welcome. There's no way you won't have. Is it food?
So, OJ, you love to be woken up at night, midnight to do it, right?
I don't care what time you want it. As long as when we're done, we just cuddle and we sleep again. Actually, when you have it in the middle, you sleep longer and you sleep better.
Okay. All right, mama. Junior mama, if I'm a mama.
So what? Okay. Do I like midnight? Not really. Because the body is tired at that time. Not really. So we could do it before sleep.
Okay, if I'm a mama, what if they wake you up with a head? Do you push him away or something like that? Are you going to push him away?
With a head.
Head. Cabbage. You know? Cabbage. chopping down there. It's part of waking you up. Yeah, because women always wake men up.
Not tapping me.
No, not tapping you. Like actually doing something. Do you push it away?
I know. Yeah, I'll wake up. Yeah, that's fine. That won't work. Winifred won't say no to that either. That's fine. You didn't ask her that.
The way Winifred, no, it's because of your answer. That's why I asked you. But the way Winifred was talking, Winifred will push you away.
What if I don't like head?
Okay, you think.
What if I don't like somebody giving me the head?
So far, I'm not sore down there. That's okay by me. Unless there's soreness or whatever. Yeah. Okay. Anybody has anything else to say before I move to the next question? Okay, we good? Okay. Does a wedding ring on a guy stop you from flirting? Fred.
You should answer that.
What did you say?
Does a wedding ring on a guy stop you from flirting?
I said you should take
you
that.
You mean with the guy?
Yeah, just like a married guy. Does it stop you from flirting with the married guy? Winifred, take it away.
No, absolutely not. It doesn't.
Okay. OJ.
Yeah.
Answer.
I will know my limits though.
Yeah, once you're taken, it's like I have a barrier.
They said flirting. They didn't say
flirting. Are you talking about when you're driving on the road and somebody winks and you wink back?
That's all flirting. Yeah. It could be your coworker, it could be a friend, you know, it's married and you guys flirt. It's flirting. No? Okay. Former.
Yeah, it wouldn't stop me. We're not dating. I'm not gonna date with the guy. It's just flirting, being friendly. I won't, because if you're in for it, yeah, flirt and everybody will go home to their partners.
It doesn't stop shit at all.
It doesn't stop me either.
Exactly. Okay. Next question. Most sexually excitable spot on your body. Hugo, take it away. What is the most sexually excitable spot on your body?
You mean able to touch, yeah?
Exactly. The most excitable, yeah.
Hey, the life wires.
The life wires. That's another word for it.
My life wire is the boobs.
The what?
Book. Ara, yeah. Ara. Okay. Giga hala man. Everything I woke up here, no coke, no kwa here today.
No, here. Yeah. You know, the last 2 weeks they were invited specifically for the program. So, but I sent them. I don't know if they're going to come, but yeah, the guys. Yeah, so. Okay. Benson. Okay, it's coming in.
Good.
So, if I'm a mama, what's your life wire?
What's the name again in English?
What's most sexually excitable spot on your body?
I'm a man here, Nibu. I don't know the name in English.
The clit,
yeah.
All right. All right. Winifred, can you give us an answer?
My boobs.
Ooh. Yeah, I'm in the boob category. Even if you're pissing me off, yeah. Yeah.
My boobs, yeah.
Yeah. Even if I'm saying no, and you make mistakenly thought, I'm like, okay. Okay, it's 4:34 now. We're gonna go to commercial. If I'm taking it away to our commercial before.
Thank you, everyone.
Do we have time for one more question?
It's time to say thank you to those who have been supporting us and plead with you to patronize them to get this business running.
Natura, Natura, Natura International, shipping, clearing with a difference. Natura ship to all part of the world. Part of our services are work on your behalf in searching and buying equipment, truck, cars, machinery, until they get to their final destination. Global freight forwarding, air freight and cargo, warehousing, consolidation, construction of oil and gas equipment, and display cars and truck for sale at a competitive prices. Natura, Natura International. Natura.
All right, thank you, Natura, for supporting us. To the next question. Guys want to know, why do women go to the bathroom together? And does anything noteworthy tend to happen in those ladies' room meetings? Winifred, can you take it away? Why do women go to the bathroom together? And does anything noteworthy tend to happen in those meetings? Winifred, are you there? Okay, Oche, can you take it away for us?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, women go to the bathroom together because maybe you're out on a date or you're out clubbing or partying, and then you tell your friend, let's go to the bathroom. You just go to the bathroom there to go and, you know, say some stuff about the guy you're with or somebody you have seen there or somebody you are, that is admiring you or somebody you are admiring or your cutting eyes and all of that. You know, so we go to the bathroom to go and discuss all of that because you wouldn't be nice saying all those things in the presence of the person or people there. So you sneak into the bathroom to go and do a little bit of ushering, you know, and then you come out and pretend like nothing happened. Maybe you're looking for moral support for the person to tell you yes, you know, go ahead.
All right, Oja, take it away.
Yeah, sometimes if you are having a date and it's going south, you take that break with a friend of yours to plot your escape route. She might come up with, oh, I have an emergency, and then two of you take off. Anyhow, the bathroom break is always like an alliance and where you plan and unplan. That's basically what we go to do there. And then for those who like makeup, that want to be on point at every given time, they need to look at the mirror, touch up, make sure that everything is in place, especially if they fancy who they are having the date with.
All right, Mama.
Yeah. I like female friends a lot. I like them a lot. I like hanging out around them. I feel more comfortable with them. I gist more with guys sometimes, but my girlfriends, I cherish them, all of you. So, same reason, go there for a chit chat and that's it.
For me, I'm shy walking out from a venue alone. So I like the support of me and somebody walking out and, you know, talking while we're going so that I don't feel like I'm going to fall down. So that's it for me. All right, next question. Do girls honestly like the nice guys? Oje, take it away.
Yes, I've never understood the concept or the notion that girls like bad boys. I don't know why. I don't. If I look at you and you even appear a bit rough, I'm skeptical, I'm edgy, and I don't want to go further. So I always, always like the nice ones.
All right, Mama.
I like the bad guys.
Their words.
Okay.
I don't Winifred.
Like the nice ones. Yeah. I like the bad guys because I'm an explorer. I want to see what makes that person bad. But again, I'm always liking them, but I have a plot to escape them, not to date them. You're bad in your own level, but they're bad. Are they badder than them? Rather than anybody making me too dull. No, I don't need it.
All right. Winifred. I like bad boys. Yeah. You know, I like the mystery, the danger, the fun, you know, they don't care about anything, you know, they just do what they want to do. And that's just the thing, you know, it's just fun. You know that this relationship is harmful or whatever, but you just like the danger, you know, you just want to keep on going, you know, at that rate with that person. So I just like the bad boys.
For me, I wouldn't call it bad for me. I like the nasty, I don't know if nasty is the right one, but I prefer the nasty ones because I have guys who I really, really liked and they're so good. And they keep asking me, like they'll ask me years later, why didn't you say yes? I said, because you were busy speaking English, telling me how you love me, you know what I mean? I don't like preambles. I don't like too much talk. I like people who just, you know, I like you, they get down to business. So I'll say I like the nasty, which might be the bad boys. I don't like all those nice, you know, English talking and stuff like that. Okay, moving on to the next question.
Has something to say.
No, you are.
You mean activity guys?
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. I don't like flower. They'll right. Bring flower today. Bring gum tomorrow. What am I talking about? I don't have anything to talk about. I want to do the
Benson group. Wants to talk, Ijama.
Oh, I'm sorry, Benson. Go ahead.
Please, so this one, bad guy. There should be a definition of bad guy now. Bad guy in what nasty. Context?
That's okay. Ifoma, can you explain a bad guy?
Yes, my definition of a
bad guy in what context?
Ifoma is explaining.
Let me explain. Okay, so I'll start with the nice guy. What the world or what majority see as a nice guy is that guy that doesn't they believe in quotes. Doesn't womanize, doesn't like, drink, doesn't like nightlife. He goes to work and comes back. Mm-hmm. That is anybody that does the other others that you that's capable of womanizing, capable of drinking, smoking, clubbing. That's a bad guy in how the world says it. Not the people that kill. We're not talking about killers. We're not talking about killers, like, murderers or thieves. No. We're talking about people who are very sociable. Those are the people they see as bad guys. So those are who I describe as a bad guy. This.
Right.
So which is what you're saying is positively bad guys, not negatively bad guys.
Yeah. Not criminally bad guys. Like criminally. Guy that will come into my life. I have a boyfriend, and the guy will take me away from my boyfriend. That's a bad dude. So he knows the buttons to press to take me away from him. That's a bad dude. Yeah.
They want what they want.
Exactly. They know what they want. They go, yes. Yes. Yeah. All right. Okay. Moving to the next question. How does a guy politely ask for a blowjob? For my mama, take it away. Like a guy wants a blowjob. You know what I mean? How do they politely ask for a blowjob?
They will. I have not experienced it. I heard
allergic to that question.
I heard that they will touch your head, push your head down. Then you know what?
Okay. So you like sign language? Okay.
Are you not there? Right.
Let's go to the extreme of you. Oje, can you tell us how a nice guy can ask for a blowjob from a girl? Let's go from bad, if I'm a mama, to good, Oje.
No, I don't even agree with Ifoma's definition of a bad guy, honestly.
No, we're talking about blowjob now.
No, it's okay. She can talk about that.
It connects because that I say somebody is nice doesn't mean he has to be boring, okay? You understand? Like, I don't drink. I don't take alcohol. But my husband does.
But you're always high.
He has this bottle of wine that he takes. Sometimes he offers me, but I never take. Okay. And then for all the best experiences and outings I've had were with him. So in as much as I consider him a nice guy, I have fun with him. That's why I don't agree that, oh, it's the bad ones that, you know, go out and that are outgoing and social and all that. So coming to the present question, I never get pushed.
He's a good guy. He's a good guy. See? That's why you're lucky with him.
Let's pray.
Yeah, you're safe with different mama. You're safe with your husband with different mama. Yeah, you're safe.
Okay, see, we have a code we normally use. You know, because of the French background, something we say it in French, we call it tout inclus, as in all inclusive. Okay? So sometimes when he wants that, he would say, are you going to give me tout inclus, all inclusive? And then I'll make the Inyanga that is there and say, before you get to that clue and all that. So, and sometimes it also depends you on your mood to go ahead and give that if you want to give a treat.
All right.
So, most times, a good guy or whatever doesn't need to ask because, you know, it's give and take. So,
no, you know, at times you guys might be watching TV. You guys might be watching TV. You know, your head go there. Then you get the question. You do the good. You know what I mean? It doesn't have to be you guys. It doesn't have to be all inclusive. At times it's just a jack off. At times it's just a temporary. Oh yeah, no, that's when the
natural can kill with all the head.
Okay. Yes. Winifred, can you take it away? Your thing is on mute.
Winnie.
What was the question?
How does a guy politely ask for a blowjob?
I don't think there's any polite way of asking for it though. You know?
You don't like
It can happen while we're drinking, when you step out of the shower or whatever. I don't think there's any way because if you come out openly to tell me, oh baby, come and give me a blowjob, that's a no-no for me. I won't do it.
So you how know? Would they ask you? How would they ask you?
It has to, my dear, all these things, just like OJ said, there's a code for it or whatever. You might just be staring at each other, you might just be, you know, you're already wet or whatever it is, and maybe the way he's smiling at you and all about your, maybe you want to get him more honey and all that is that. Nah, riaria na ho small small na gabia because they manali he na gime and all. I don't think there's any polite way. Nobody has ever politely asked me to come and give him a head. But
okay, all right. For me, I'm the kind of head guy. So. No, because the question specifically said, how does a guy politely ask you? So to me, it doesn't necessarily mean during sex. It could be doing anything. You guys could be driving. He could be driving and he wants it. Yeah. So to me, he could be driving and he wants it. Okay.
He just says, well, driving.
Do you have anything to say? No. Okay. The next question is, for women who get their periods, what does it feel like? Winifred, go ahead. For women who get their periods, what does it feel like? Guys want to know how we feel, what it feels like for us to be in our period.
With the cramps and all of that, it's painful already. And then with the cramps and, you know, some people feel nauseous and all. I only experience cramps and the heavy bleeding and all. Apart from that, nothing more.
Yeah, mama.
It's uncomfortable, actually. It's really uncomfortable.
All right, mama.
It's two-way feelings for me. When I'm in a good mood, I could tell you I don't like it. I want it to come and go fast. It's not painful for me. It's okay. But when you want to make some excuses, you wish for it to come. Those days, you wish for to come. So when you're doing some kind of visiting, you know why there will be a no-go area? Because I'm on my period.
All right, Oje, go ahead.
Yeah, oh, okay. When I was younger, I always had migraines. It's in recent years, I think the moment I hit 40, I now started having cramps, okay? But not as bad as the average person, because I see how some people cannot really do anything. The migraines are there, but I get very impatient. Mm-hmm. If I'm trying to explain something and you're not getting it, I just get mad. That's what I know that comes with mine. I get very, very irritable. So yes. I tend not to talk. I'd rather be with my
mood swings.
You say the wrong thing, I'll just get mad at you.
And you start crying, Abby?
Of course. I can't be mad without crying. It's not possible.
For me, I'm one of the lucky ones. I don't have cramps. I don't have cramps. I don't bleed heavily. It doesn't stop me from having sex, so it's never been a problem for me. I don't feel it, so I don't even know when it's coming. So I'm one of the lucky ones. Okay, the next question is
Ashanti in the house.
Yeah, man. The next question is, why do women stop being seductive once they are comfortable with their partners? Like, after you hook a man up, whether your boyfriend, whatever, you start wearing big t-shirts, you don't dress sexy anymore and stuff like that. Why do we do that? Men want to know, why do we always do that? After having babies, you let yourself go and stuff like that. If my mama, take it away.
It's a bit difficult for me because naturally I'm not that kind of person. I'm not naturally a seductive person unless I am, and people I don't know. So I live normal even after being comfortable in a relationship. I'm still that normal person. So I'm not that kind of person. I don't act that seduction. So I don't change. It's continual. I'm on a stable ground.
Fine.
I can't boast of being very seductive person and the dancing, pole dancing style. I know Sabian. But I'm learning. Fine. I want to learn.
All right, Winifred, I'll teach you. Winifred.
You know, when a guy is toasting you and all of that, you know, you want to look your best. To always be glammed up and all that. But once the relationship hits 1 year, he has seen it all and all, you now feel comfortable, you know? It's not even, you now feel very comfortable. It's like your own brother is your person. There's nothing to hide any longer, nothing whatsoever. He sees when you dress up to go out and then I feel you now become too comfortable and relaxed. That's just the thing. It's not an intentional thing. You tell yourself, you know, you're just like that. So it's not something that we intentionally do, but it's just that we are now comfortable with the person. That's just the thing. But if we have something that we are going out to go and do, definitely we'll now glam up and head out. You know, but if it's with that person, just tell yourself, let me just go. Sometimes you even go out without makeup with himself. Is it not him? Am I going to chase another man or whatever? You know, you just, because you're comfortable, that's the word.
All right. Oje.
I can't talk on behalf of those people because I haven't stepped down. I'm not a makeup person. I'm always on point when it comes to looks because I know that this is what my husband wants. He wants me to look hot all the time. So if I'm in the house, I'm wearing my bum shorts. If I'm going out, when I'm going out with him alone, most times in the evenings is when I'm the hottest. And then when I'm at home, I'm always looking sharp. So I don't know why the others decided. And funny enough, when they see you that way, he's ever looking for stuff to buy for me to keep looking that way. So for me, I'll say to the other ladies, up your game.
Wow, good advice. You for my mama, up your game. Chinasa, do you have anything to say? Chinasa, you raised your hand. Do you have anything to say? Your foot? Yeah, go ahead.
Well, like Winifred said, for those that do that, they get too comfortable. You know, they're like, what else? What else am I looking for? I've gotten that husband, I'm okay, I'm relaxed. But for me, my advice would be for every woman, you know, always try to look good for yourself. Keep up. You know, because sometimes men, when you start being like that, especially when they didn't meet you like that, and you start being like that, it gives them room to go out and cheat or something. You know, so for me, I'm always looking good. Good or bad.
Adding to your comment, someone said that it does not encourage, that kind of behavior does not encourage marriage, rather encourages unfaithfulness. Because they start thinking, they don't see you as something anymore. So
yeah, exactly.
Advice to of us out there, look sharp, look good.
Man, I'm making my husband assignment every day.
Good.
Yeah, good. Always look good. Always look good. Make him admire you every day.
Yeah. Okay, Ego wants to say something. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yes, women naturally, most of us go through a lot, and during those early years, it's all rosy, you and your husband, less responsibility, and after some time, you find out that the woman is, maybe after birth, we get all confused and a lot of things happen, and we don't get that support, so a lot of women are going through a lot, so they might not be at their best at that time in their life. Then secondly, most men, there are things you used to do with your wife, there are things you used to do for your wife when you were courting her and all that. Are you still doing those things? When a woman gets depressed, the least on her mind is to dress up and all that, especially if it's not somebody that is naturally, there are people that without even putting an effort, they look attractive and seductive. Like if I come home and see Ijoma, even with her hair cover, I will bounce on her any day. She doesn't need to go that extra man. For me, even in my boo-boo, I'm still attractive by, you know, there is a way you still wear your boo-boo and you will be like attractive. So it doesn't matter.
If he knows you're wearing your boo-boo without panties and bra. So much.
Exactly. There are things. There are ways of rocking those traditional things and you still look sexy. But the point is, most people are going through a lot, and that alone
is true.
Will spoil the game. So you have to work on the problem to get her back.
In my ego, this thing, needs a whole new topic, because this is another perspective that, you know what I mean? Most times women, we marry between kids, job and everything, most women get depressed and they go through shit. And people don't even, especially our culture, they don't even understand the depressed part of it. I think this is something we need to talk about in depth.
It's a big issue for women. It's a mindset issue. And then with our beliefs, we have brought up so many, we have different backgrounds. Even at times you'll be dressed up at home with your husband, your mother comes in and you're like, why are you dressed like this? What if somebody walks into the house? So they keep making, before you know it, they keep putting all those, you know, our upbringing. It affects us, you know, somehow. And if the marriage is having problem, your husband is not, when was the last time you bought perfumes for your wife? When was the last time you did her laundry shopping like me? Until I separated from my husband, I never knew how to buy panties. He has always done my pants and bras. So do you do that? If you know what you want your wife to wear, why don't you buy it? It's just recently that I started buying. In fact, once or twice my mom bought for me. My husband was like, I've never seen this. Where did you get this from? Because he knows I don't buy. So do you do those things for your wife? Were you doing them? Did you continue? So you have to find the root, get to the root of the problem, honestly. If she needs help, you help her and get her back.
For me, normally, I'm a naked person. I like to run around the house naked. My kids are grown now, so it's difficult for me. But like Ego is saying, even if I wear boo-boo at home, my husband knows there's no panties or bras, you know, under it. So it's still very, very, you know, tantalizing and stuff like that. So, I think I think I'm 90% okay. Maybe 10%, I get comfortable, but I'm actually 90% okay. All right. Let's do one or two more questions before we end the segment. The next question is that, do you take it personally if a man you're sleeping with can't or couldn't come? Like the man will be doing and won't come. So if I'm a man, can you take it away from me?
Hey. there are two folds to this question, Ijama. Does it mean that he will eventually come or that he won't come till the end of the session?
No, I guess at the end of the session, some men are like that. Doesn't come. Yeah.
What has he been doing? What's the problem? Anyway.
Some people, most women can have sex and don't come. Some men it takes them.
So it's very common. It's common for women. For a man, yeah. If a man doesn't come after a long session, I will just believe that they've come somewhere and they've just come back to and not come in the house. So,
okay, Winifred, take it away.
Why do you have to be Winifred?
Please, I'm going in order now. I have to, scramble. I can't ask the same person the same thing. So, Winifred, do you have a problem with that?
Okay, repeat the question. If they don't come,
do you take it personally if a man? Do you take it personally if your man you're sleeping with can't or doesn't come?
Why won't he come? Or where has he gone to come?
So men, let me tell you, I've known men, how they can't come. You have to do orally for them to come. So like us, why it's difficult for some women to, come,
What if you do that oral and all of that and he still doesn't come?
At the end, I don't know. But do you take it personally when immature everything? And
of course, yes. Now I've done everything and all of that. And when it's like that, at the end of it all, they don't come. They still want to continue going. In a good jig, in a good gold, in a good game. The person is tired. Is tired. And you say, "What? Please make me come. I have to come. I must come. You must come. What have you been waiting for to come?
You try. You try the hand and you try the mouth."
I've tried the mouth, the all the styles, the wheelbarrow, the missionary, everything. He has not come. What else do you want me to do?
You tell him to pee. You tell him to pee with a Jesus. Oje, how would you feel? Do you take it personally if the man?
No, I don't. Because a lot of things can be the cause. If somebody is having a hard time at work, and he thought that maybe by the time he makes love to you, he would the tension would ease.
Hey, Oja called it making love. Go ahead.
So if that underlying problem is there, he has issues that he knows he's gonna go back and deal with, he might not necessarily get there. So if he tries and he's not making it, I'll politely tell you, Nagaira Honora, let us go to bed. It won't be a problem for me. We can always have another time.
I like your perspective. I'm like, for me, I don't really, really, really care because I know guys who take weed, Igbo, they can go 10 years and they will not come. So if that person if I know that person takes something like a starry looking thing or something that will make him not to come, won't bother me. But I won't take it personal. I won't take it because, to me, coming is not a big deal. You can come another time. One last question before we end the segment. Let me choose another question. If your partner is a virgin, is that a turnoff? If the guy is a virgin, if I'm 23, yeah. If your partner is a virgin, is that a turn off?
How will you know?
Oje, take it away.
It can't be a turn off because if it was a turn off, then how would I have been able to get some myself? So it's
okay.
Not
a- so you don't mind meeting a man and he doesn't know where to put it in, and when he wants to come, he's like, "I want to pee." You know what I mean? Do you want to go through all that?
I don't mind.
Okay. All right. If I'm a mama.
I don't mind either. I'll be the expert. I'll be the coach.
Winifred.
It wouldn't be a turn-off. I would be surprised at all that, And then I have to, it would be exciting for me. Yeah. To even tell you that you've met the coach. Let me teach you. Let me walk you through the room. You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's exciting for me. That's just the thing. But funny enough, I've never met any man that's a vegetarian.
That's what I'm about to say. I never met any man like I've never met any man that is a virgin, and I don't even know how I'm gonna feel about it, but I don't think I would like to teach. I'm very impatient. So I don't think I would like to teach that.
Okay.
So we come to the end of the segment. If I'm gonna take it away. Thank you everybody for joining us today. Thank you for tuning in. Stay tuned for next week's episode. Okay. If you have questions that you want us to address, please feel free. Mama, take it away.
Yep. Bye. We are taking it away. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Mama, if you don't vote of thanks.
Oh, is it me?
Fancy.
Okay. I've done that. I want to say thank you to everyone who's been a part of this evening, who had plenty of question from guys out there, as if they were waiting to ask us so many questions. We haven't gone through all of the questions, but again, when I'm receiving messages, private messages, people still want us to go on. We can't continue tonight, rightly, because of the time, but we will do that from next week. We'll continue with this session. Thank you very much. We love you all.
And music.
I treat you like a man is supposed to. You never have to cry. No. I know everyone can relate to when they find a special someone. And she's royal. Yeah. So royal. And I want her in my so one of a kind, no. The way she moves to her own beat, she has the qualities of a queen. She's a queen. Ooh, ooh, what a natural beauty. No need no makeup to be a cutie. She's a queen.
Excuse me, that guys. Excuse me, that. She's stand up and dance, everybody.
And they ask what a good woman's made of. She's not afraid and ashamed of who she is. She's royal, yeah. So royal.
Go to that. Stand up for that.
I never knew anyone so one of a kind until the night that I seen her eyes.
I see you looking.
My queen, so sweet. I can see it in her eyes, the way she smiles.
Thank you guys, thank you everybody. Be well, be safe. Have a good
night.
Yeah. Be on the yeah, yeah.
Yaga, spiritual. Le Faxa music, Imani.
Baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Reverse, baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Show me your particular, baby, pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
In a light, baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Back. Baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Reverse. Baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Show me your particular. Baby, pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
In a light, baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
If in a man, they make me the follow your lane. They follow your lane. I like how you dance. I want make you follow me play. You follow me play. If in a man, they make me the follow your lane.
They follow your lane.
I like how you dance. I want make you follow me play. Feeling you badly, you they making me want to go nutty. I'll take you round the world, my baby, oh, baby, baby, na na.
Baby, you pull over. Baby, you pull over.
Reverse, baby, you pull over.
Baby, you pull over.
Show me your.
All right, Ifeoma with Aminsa, stopping the music. All right, I guess it's time for us to go.
Mm-hmm. Good night, everyone.
All right, good night. Good night.
Good night.
Thank you, Benson.
If you good?
Bye.
Thank you, Ego.
Yeah.
I don't even know what I'm doing. I was playing with my...
That's okay. I'm good.